says, will there be more sirens?
Whoa.
That's an interesting answer. Could Emerson be a mermaid?
I love your series. Thank you.
Thank you.
That's really nice of you.
I love our series too.
Aww. Me too. Well, as you like heard before, no one will ever give me a tail. So I won't be a tail.
She wants to be in a tail. Like, she asked me to be in a tail. Sorry, Emerson. Maybe we can like do a swimming video with you just for fun if you want. Would you like that?
I don't know.
Would you guys like to see her swimming just for fun?
Oh, like you may have a tail.
Yeah, just you.
Yeah.
And more sirens.
That would be cool.
I think Michelle is enough, you guys.
Oh yeah.
For now, I'm not seeing more sirens in the series. Maybe more mermaids, but I don't know if more sirens. But for now,
it's
Michelle
not
is
spoiling anything. Yeah.
But we want you guys to be happy, so if there's something that you really want to see, tell us.
Yeah,
yes, definitely.
We'd love to hear.
Write us everything you want to see. We love hearing your comments.
We definitely check the comment sections very frequently, so if you have anything to tell us,
I read all of your comments, guys.
Me too.
Every single one.
We love comments. Go.
Artistic Bean says, other than Mystia, do you guys have any other series in mind? Can we see more mermaid tales in the episodes?
Okay, for the first question,
I want to make more stuff.
I would love to do more
can
stuff,
we please?
But we have no time on our hands.
Yeah. And every time we do have on our hands, we're working on this. But
Yeah, I mean, if we had more time, we'd probably do more stuff, but like,
I think if
we barely have time for Mystia.
It'll happen.
You can't
very later.
I'm sure we will work on some new projects in the future.
You can see in the YouTube channel a couple of videos that are from Adiza.
I started film school, so I do work on other projects that don't have to do with Mystia.
Mm-hmm.
And so most of them. But nothing that we work on together, like no new series.
Yeah, entire story.
Yeah.
Maybe
in the future, yeah.
It.
And for the other question.
The tales.
You guys, I have to tell you something.
You have to tell me something?
I have to tell you something.
Tale.
It's super hard to film with the tales. Like, it's super
hard.
Yeah. We do have more swimming scenes in the season.
Yeah.
But it's pretty hard to get that done because we don't have much clear water where we live, we don't have a pool, and we cannot film in the ocean that is close to our house, so we have to drive really, really far to film swimming scenes.
So we try to make most of the swimming scenes, like film them in one day or something like that, and there are more swimming scenes, like don't worry, don't think like we're not doing anything. But there are more tail scenes, there are more swimming seal scenes, it's just a little...
Also that! Not in this season, but
who knows? But it's harder to make, it's harder to do.
And you're also going to see Michelle swimming this season, because we haven't seen her swimming this season yet, so...
Delmar Mermaid says,
hey!
When or how did you come up with the idea to start the show?
What was it, 3 years ago?
Yeah, it was
more than that!
No, 3 years ago.
3 years?
Yeah. I write a lot and we film a lot of stuff, not for YouTube or anything like that, for ourselves. So I wanted to do something that we can actually upload and share with everyone, something fun. We love fantasy and we wanted to do something that's a little bit crazy and a little bit like adventurous and magical. And that's how it
and
came
mermaid.
To be.
We started writing something a long, long time ago that was way too complicated. We built an entire world that had a lot of inside rules, but creating the series that we wrote, it was way too ambitious. Like, there was a kingdom on a cloud, which, like...
Nice!
Come on!
I mean,
CGI. Hey, maybe in the future!
It was so cool.
Yeah,
it was
a really cool idea.
Danielle Belgard says, besides Luna and Michelle, will there be more mermaids? I would like Blossom to come back and also be a mermaid.
Blossom will not be a mermaid.
It's like, I feel like every show or movie somehow makes everyone like the same type of thing. It's like if someone's mythical, so you can't leave the other characters not mythical at all. And it kind of it kind of undermines the diversity and the conflict. Because, yeah, like, if there's a superhero show, if you see a superhero movie, like, during the time, everyone becomes a superhero. Like, if you have a couple of seasons, they can't go without making everyone superheroes. And I feel like it kind of ruins the conflict and ruins the differences. And there's a lot of meaning behind a person that isn't with a power, or isn't a mermaid, or isn't a mythical creature. There's a lot of power to it. And we're not saying that nothing will happen or no character is not going to change. It's like... But but we don't want to make everyone like a mermaid.
On my cube
asks us, one, what will May play in the series now? Will she play Blossom again?
We don't know.
She will be helping us with the series, but probably not as Blossom.
But maybe.
But hey, we can never know.
Two, in your opinion, which character is most interesting this season?
Okay, so what I like most interesting is the difficult question, because like the character I like best is Michelle. I'm biased, but because I've had a lot of time to relate to her and to get to know the character. And but most interesting, it's like all the characters in the season, and in general, there's a lot you don't know about. It's like we're finding out with the characters and with Michelle or with the other characters a lot about everyone. So every character is really interesting in its own way.
I really don't know how to answer this question. I thought about it earlier and I don't know even now, because just like Gal, I do like Emerson because I'm most connected to her, and I had like really interesting time getting to know her as a character. But most of my what if, it's like about Luna and Michelle, because I know their backstory and I know there is a lot more to know about them, but I'm just like curious to see more of them. I think there is a lot more to see.
I mean, I do think that every character is interesting and surrounded with mystery.
We're very politically correct.
Yeah, we are. But like, if I had to take just one that I personally want to concentrate on, one that I want to learn more about, it would be Emerson 1000%. She like feels so intriguing in terms of character development and story, so I definitely want
to... Such a mermaid who lived in Earth for like 14 years?
Yeah,
for like 14 years!
14 years! Yeah!
But yeah, like Luna, you don't know almost anything about her so far. You found out a little bit.
I think that Luna is a very open book, so even though you don't know all of her backstory, you kind of get to know her pretty fast. So
she likes it.
That's why
you
can connect to her pretty fast. And I don't know. I really like Michelle because you never know everything about Michelle. Even though you get to know her through the season and you already saw a full season of her, you never know everything there is to know about her. There is always something that she doesn't say or maybe doesn't even know about herself.
Yeah.
I can't choose between my children, guys. I write all of them. I'm connected to all of them because I write all of them.
There's like, because of Luna is such an open book and so easy to relate to, so Michelle also knows her for a long time, even though she's closed and suspicious, she feels very comfortable with Luna. Whereas in, because both Michelle and Emerson are very closed characters and very suspicious characters, they can't trust easily, so they kind of clash one with another, which is also very interesting to see.
In your opinion, which is the coolest episode in the series?
Oh my god.
Ooh. Wow. I have two answers. One, the coolest episode, I think, is the one with the dragon, because it's super impressive and it came out really good. And praise.
So in the series, I'm talking the season.
In the series, I'm gonna say the one with the dragon. But my favorite scene, and the only reason it's my favorite scene is because it was so much fun to film, is the scene where I'm the trident.
That's the best scene.
It's intense and it's empowering and it's so much fun.
I loved the scene.
That was my absolute favorite scene.
I loved the episode with the Lady of the Lake.
Yes! I loved the episode. Also, it was Yay.
For me, I think it was the most fun to film.
Most of the season 2 episodes are really, really cool. Like,
yeah,
the last episode that we posted, the Thank fourth you. Episode.
Okay, perfect.
The fourth episode yeah. is really, yeah. really cool. Like, if you guys haven't seen it yet, you really, really like, should.
We also definitely should. Yeah, this isn't.
Okay. And yeah. I really like the swimming scenes, even though when we do it, it's frozen cold. It's so cold.
It definitely
but
is.
These days are so much fun.
But you guys, just you wait, because there are going to be a lot more cool episodes this season.
It's true.
Yay.
Very true. So, Adi kinda said it herself, the one that I think is the coolest and the one that I had the most fun filming was the Watchmaker episode, the one that is on the channel right now. We're going to probably link to it at the end of this video, so go ahead and watch it if you didn't yet, because it's really worth it.
Yeah.
It's really worth your time.
Hans here, celebrate today, guys.
Five Fibers in Fiction says, to Luna and Triton.
Oh?
If Triton isn't here.
If you could have any celebrity guest star on the show, who would they be? Why and what kind of characters would they be?
I said David
immediately.
Tennant.
Oh, nice, okay.
I'm gonna go with David Tennant.
Me too!
Because he's incredible and he can play any character. He can play any shit. I don't care.
She actually met David Tennant.
Yes, I have! I've met David Tennant. I have a picture of him.
Can I put the picture?
In the US?
Yeah,
you can. I'm
gonna put the picture.
Yeah, sure.
I mean, the first one that comes to mind is my friend who's also kind of my workmate in the dubbing and voice acting industry. Her name is Shil Katzenel, and
she
manages most of the Israeli business in the mermaid fandom and world in general.
The only answer I can think of is the three actresses from H2O.
Nice,
yeah.
Okay!
Yeah,
that
oh
was
my god, I love
them!
That's like, they're like my favorite mermaids ever, they are still. And it would be totally awesome to see them like in tail in real life.
Yeah, H2O is like our childhood.
Yeah, SC Mermaid says, what is the process of choosing music, like, for your videos?
I like to think of the characters and what they are and how they act and, like, what their storyline is. Like, when I choose a music for Luna, it's very happy, it's very tropical, it's very, like, swimming and fun, and Michelle is very intense. It's a very intense music.
I choose
music for each character and also for each scenario, like, if there is an action scene, there is music for that, and if there is just like a scene where you guys talk or walk or whatever, there are other kinds of pieces of music.
You can't believe the change the music does in an episode.
Yeah, for sure. I choose the music according to the scene and how it affects it, and like, if you put different kinds of music to the same scene, it makes the scene
completely
different, yeah, so.
Magenta Mermaid 678 says, which video was the most fun to film?
Every day of filming is kind of insane in its own way, and there's days that are full, long days of filming, and it's really fun.
I really liked filming some of Luna's swimming scene in the first episode, because we filmed her a lot, so at some point I switched places with Adi and I filmed a little bit, so it was kind of fun to like be underwater and try and film with a camera that I can't see anything, because it's a small camera, I couldn't see anything, I couldn't.
I mean, I feel like every filming day is an adventure.
Yeah, I
like every time we film, there is some adventurous thing that we do.
I know.
It's like going on a trip. We always
Was it
do a lot of walking, do a lot of driving.
Okay.
Like when we filmed in the cave of the 7th episode, we had to climb up a big mountain. Like we didn't even know that there is another way around it. Like we
actually remembered right now, but the scene that I had the most fun filming was the one with the fire.
When
Michelle and Luna talked, and I was like eating a chicken on the side of the camp, and I was like, she told me like to eat it with my hand, and I was like, okay, so Emerson lives in the woods, so she's eating like a girl who lives in the woods, so I was like, ah.
liked it. Maybe I should live in the woods.
How long does it take to film one scene? And do you guys have to reshoot scenes a lot?
Oh,
I think we reshoot anything.
No, I don't think we reshoot. We don't have time to reshoot stuff.
No,
we still have more stuff to film that we haven't filmed yet.
We make every scene and then we do it from a different angle and we do it. Something goes wrong in the middle of the scene, so
if we think it can be done better, we do it again, but we don't just reshoot if we don't see any problem. But in terms of the time, it really depends on just how long the scene is, how much we mess or don't mess up.
I think for the most part, it takes about an hour to film, to shoot one scene.
Yeah. It depends.
About an hour, maybe less, maybe more.
Like,
in average, it's an hour.
Amina Garibova says, why does it take so long to upload?
Because we don't have time to film.
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry, but we don't.
We do have a lot of the next episodes, but it's a lot of editing to do, and I'm a student, I'm in the university. Mm-hmm. I don't have time for that. Like, I try really hard to edit the episodes as fast as I can, but it's a lot of editing to do, so there's episodes
with a lot of editing in them, and then there's episodes that we like we film in noisy places, or we have to drive really far to film, and then we have to make an entire day out of it or an entire weekend out of it. So to find time to film takes time, and to record the sound, because everything's really loud.
And like, four of us are in college or university, right?
Yeah. Also, guys, that's very nice. But also, I don't want to upload a bunch of episodes in like a row, because then you guys won't have content. I mean, we only have 12 episodes. It's a lot of episodes, but it's still not that many episodes. So if we just upload a bunch of episodes, you guys are going to finish them, and then we don't have anything else to upload. So
yeah, from the same person. What's all the cast members' favorite ice cream?
Oh!
Chocolate!
Salted caramel.
Ooh.
I love salted caramel.
Mine is cheesecake. Cheesecake and ice cream.
Ben and Jerry's...
Ben and Jerry.
Cookie dough.
I love their brownies and their
chocolate. Yeah, the brownies are so good!
Yeah.
But mine's just plain and simple, vanilla.
Yeah, we're out of questions, so...
Yay!
I hope you guys got your answers and learned what you want to know about us. I mean, what our favorite ice cream is.
the most important thing.
It was the most important question.
We do. Ice cream is great.
And leave as many comments as possible.
Really.
But if you're writing a comment, be sure that we'll read it and
try to answer as many as we possibly can.
Yeah.
So we really care about what you have to say.
Yeah, okay. So tell us like what you want to see in the series, which new mythical creatures you want to see, whatever you guys asked us. Like,
what is your favorite place?
Who are you guys?
What would the color of your tail be?
So what's your favorite episode?
Yeah, well,
who's your favorite character?
Oh, wow.
And who's your least favorite?
And who do you guys ship with each other?
Yeah!
Oh, that's a good question.
Need you to stay.
Thank you for all these great questions.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for helping us do this.
Be sure to follow us on Instagram, follow us on Facebook, and follow us on Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
We have all these pages.
And subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Also, press the bell button, because some of you guys don't get notification when we upload new episodes.
I do.
So if you press the bell button, you know when we upload a new episode, and that's really fun. Okay.
Yeah, and so, like or favorite this video if you enjoyed it. We really appreciate it.
Yeah.
And until next time,
love you guys.
Love you guys. Bye.